What time of day should I take Enclomiphene? Now, this is really important because in this video, I'm going to explain to you why the morning is the best time to take Enclomiphene. I'm going to talk to you about what it does, both for dudes and for ladies. I'm going to talk to you about why it's probably more powerful than like Clomid, especially for men. And I'm also going to deconstruct how you can utilize Enclomiphene for a more natural expression of testosterone. So by the end of this video, you'll be able to know exactly when to take Enclomiphene, you'll know how to follow your circadian rhythms, and even how to time it based on your menstrual cycle for you ladies. So let's jump in. I'm Regan Archibald, founder of Ageless Future. You can go to agelessfuture.com. Make sure you get blood labs with us because Enclomiphene, this molecule is very powerful. This is not a peptide. It's a small molecule that does stimulate the release of LH or luteinizing hormone and follicular stimulating hormone. And so anytime you're messing around with hormones, whether it's through a small molecule, a peptide, a hormone, you want to make sure that you're working with professionals. So this is not medical advice. This is me sharing my clinical expertise and some of the great research that's been done on what I think is one of the most powerful ways of increasing testosterone through the use of Enclomiphene. So how many of you have low testosterone? And how many of you actually know if you have low testosterone or not? And why is that even important? Well, testosterone is a hormone that for a long time, we all looked at it as if it were just for people who wanted performance enhancement. And now that we've dug deeper, I believe testosterone is one of the most foundational tools for longevity. Because I look at this, I call it the ageless axis. It's the health of the muscles, it's the health of your heart, and it's the health of your brain. These organ systems are what will keep you feeling great, performing great, being active, being able to get up and down off a chair, off the toilet, you know, just the basic things as we age. It's testosterone, because testosterone for the brain, it helps activate dopamine, so it makes effort feel good. Testosterone, you've got receptors in that prefrontal cortex, so better for analytical thinking. You have a little better clarity and cognition. In the muscles, testosterone allows you to hold on to muscle. Testosterone allows for greater muscle hydration and growth. And then in the heart, testosterone, you've got massive quantities. More tissue has need for testosterone in your heart than your entire body combined. So just thinking through that lens, it's like, okay, well, testosterone's very important, but what happens when you take external testosterone and put it into your body? Sometimes your body, not sometimes, but your body will stop making its own testosterone. And I want you to get high on your own supply. I mean, the pharmacy between your ears is the safest and most effective pharmacy you could ever access. And so anytime you're taking it in exogenously, it's called a feedback loop. So your brain will say, oh, Reagan's already got testosterone, so we don't need to make any more because he's covered. And then that leads to what's called hypogonadism. So that's the shrinkage of the testicles. And that can be problematic because we want you to have nice, healthy testicles. And I won't explain why, but if you think of it, using Enclomiphene, one of the reasons why you want to use it in the morning is because testosterone naturally is higher. Around 9 a.m. is where testosterone peaks. That's where we can get a little frisky. But if you're using Enclomiphene, you want to use it in the morning so you can get your natural expression of testosterone. And one of the things that happens when you do take testosterone is you can have an increase of the active version of the testosterone hormone called DHT, and that can cause some baldness or hair loss. The other thing that can happen with testosterone is it turns off spermatogenesis. So these Leydig cells in your testicles are what trigger the production of sperm. And for those of you who want to have kids, and I'm a big proponent, have lots of babies, but you won't be having the same ability for fertilization if you're using testosterone. So one thing that's been used in fertility clinics, we've used it for years in our clinic, is we want to increase your testosterone in a more natural way, meaning I want you to produce as much as you possibly can. And so what Enclomiphene enclomiphene has been shown to do is it does increase the luteinizing and follicular stimulating hormones. Now make sure that you have your labs and you say, okay, what's your total testosterone, your free testosterone? Has your LH and FSH levels? And what do your sex hormone binding globulins look like? And then if you are on testosterone therapy and you're saying, man, I'm feeling side effects, or I want to cycle off of it, give my body a break so I can make my own, well, this is where enclomiphene can be just a lifesaver. Because enclomiphene, whether you're taking 12.5 milligrams or 25 milligrams, either daily, every other day, you're going to get that increase of this sensitivity where the gonadotropin-releasing hormone gets activated through enclomiphene, which in turn activates your LH and FSH. And then what you'll see is you'll have an increase in the Leydig cells, which increases your testosterone. It also protects your sperm. And so in women, what you'll see is when you have higher levels of FSH and LH, you're going to have better follicle formation, and this will help in your menstruation and ovulation. So if you do it in the morning dose, morning aligns with your natural circadian rhythms, right as the endocrine system peaks with testosterone. And then your follicular phase dosing is what you need following your infradian rhythms for the ovaries. So that's the best time to take it as female. So if you have a tracker, look for your follicular cycle. If you're a man, let's just kind of jump into it. So men, what enclomiphene does is it flips on the switch for testosterone production. And the thing that happens as we get stressed, the stress is a killer for testosterone. What you'll notice is there's that pathway called the gonadotropin-releasing hormone. And anytime your body's under stress, it thinks we need to conserve energy. And so the body can survive without the reproductive system. So if you have poor sexual function, poor libido, there's a good chance that you have too much stress in your nervous system and the gonadotropin-releasing hormone is turned off. The other stressor that turns it off are infections. A lot of our clients, we find that they have massive infections, mycotoxin, biotoxic infections, infections from Lyme, Epstein-Barr viruses, long COVID, bacterial infections in the gut are not uncommon. And that also turns off your testosterone production. And then the final thing that we've seen is if you have chemical exposures. So a lot of the plastics, a lot of the food that you're eating that's loaded with chemicals, these are estrogen mimicries. And so they mimic the hormones in your body. And then your body doesn't have the receptors to actually pull in the testosterone or the estrogen or the progesterone. And so it throws all of the hormones out of balance because of these hormone mimickers. So when you think about this overall process, number one is if you do test yourself and you're like, I have low testosterone or suboptimal, then you want to say, okay, why is that? And then you want to go through this. Do I have emotional stress that I could clear out? Is there any pain in my body that needs to be resolved? Are there infections that need to be cleared out? What kind of chemicals am I exposed to that I'm not even aware of that I could get rid of? That's the foundational piece. So then you focus on nutrition. Are you exercising? You know, in one of the studies, they took men who had low testosterone, sent them out in the woods. They camped with each other for 2 weeks. They chopped wood. They did physical labor. When they came back, the testosterone levels had doubled and in some case tripled than before they went to the woods. So maybe you just need to go camp with a bunch of dudes and cut down trees. I don't know, but that does seem to work. So women, it's the same thing. Are there infections? Are there chemical exposures? You know, the makeup, it's the perfumes, all those things, the fragrances, they have chemicals that can block your hormones. How's your food? Are you eating healthy, clean food? How's your emotional health? These are all really important things to handle up front. And then when you think about, okay, I've handled all those things, I still am at suboptimal levels, then look at your LH and FSH pathway. If you've got runway there, dudes, then that's where enclomiphene can be really helpful. And it's helpful in multiple ways. It's great for fertility for both men and women, helps maintain your sperm. It also helps increase testosterone naturally. So if you love this video, and if you're wondering, how can I go a little deeper on not just enclomiphene, but I want to see what other peptides I may be able to use, like gonadotropin or kisspectin, then grab a copy of my book. It's a free download, The Peptide Blueprint, and you can just nerd out on that. And I hope you love it, and I will see you on the next video.